Okay, so now the next topic is to find out the length of the belt for the open belt system. So this is the meaning of open belt system. You can see there is one pulley here, other pulley is here, and the belt is running like this from outside. In this case, the direction of rotation is going to remain the same. So suppose this is the clockwise direction, then this will also be clockwise direction. The direction of rotation will remain the same, which is quite obvious. Now our job here is to find out the length of the belt when we are given this condition. So what is given here, I'll write here, given. You are given D, that is the center distance between the two pulleys. Then you are given the radius R1 and radius R2. That means the radius of first pulley R1, radius of the second pulley R2, D is the center distance. So with only this much information, you are supposed to find out the length of the belt. Now why this much information? Because this is the information which is easy to measure. It is possible, it is very easy to measure the diameter of one pulley, diameter of the other pulley, and the center distance, which is possible to measure. But then as you see here, we are going to arrive at the formula for the length by making use of some kind of a geometry involved over here. So let us see how this is done. First, look at this figure. Now you will find that the belt is in contact with pulley from this point to this point. After that, this part is not in contact. From here, again it is in contact with smaller pulley, from this point to this point, and from this point, again it is not in contact. So you see that the total length of the belt, you can see, it is divided into three parts. One is the part which is in contact with one pulley, plus the part which is in contact with the second pulley, plus twice the distance which is not in contact. Why twice? Because one here and one here. So twice this much distance which is not in contact, plus this, that becomes the total length of the belt. So I'll write here, length of the belt let us call this as capital L. So this L is equal to now this radius is R2, so I'll write R2 into angle. Now the angle of contact, see the belt is in contact from this point to this point. So if you want to measure this curvature arc, what is the length of this arc? The length of this arc is radius into angle. Radius into angle. Now this angle you have to measure in radians. I'll write here radians by symbol. So theta radians. Now radius is shown by letter C, not R. C stands for radians. So this angle theta 2 is measured in radians. So that angle multiplied by R2 becomes the curvature. Now from where this formula has come? That arc is R into theta. See, if you take any arc, I'll draw one small arc. This radius, this is angle theta. So this is R theta. This part of the arc is equal to radius into angle, where angle is in radians. Now from where this has come is, if you take a circle and if you measure angle this much, how much is this angle? Full angle is 2 pi. So this angle in this case is 2 pi. Radius is R. So here radius into angle R theta. Here radius into angle is R 2 pi. So if you measure distance from here up to here, that comes to R 2 pi. What is R 2 pi? 2 pi R. 2 pi R is a perimeter, circumference. So circumference of the circle has come like this. 2 pi R. 2 pi is angle, this is 2 pi. And R is R. So same thing here, angle is, instead of 2 pi it is theta, and radius is R. But remember, this angle is not in degrees, it is in radians. So here 2 pi is in radians, and then the radius is R. We are not taking 360 degrees. So it is not R into 360 degrees, it is R into 2 pi radians. Okay, what is 2 pi radians? 2 into 3.14. 2 pi means 2 into 3.14, because we know pi is 3.14. So 6.28 radians is this part, 6.28 into radius, that is the circumference. So that is the general formula. This is what is applied here. So length of the belt is R2 theta 2 plus, I'll write here, R2 theta 2 radians plus R1 theta 1 radians plus 2 times what? let this explanation be there. Two times this length, this much length, this length. Now how much is this length? For finding out this length, we have to do some construction. So see here what is done. From the center of this smaller circle, we have drawn a perpendicular on this radius. So that this is a rectangle. This is a rectangle, opposite side same. Because this is R1, this is R1. So if this is R1 and this full is R2, then this is R2 minus R1. Full is R2, this is R1. So this is R2 minus R1. Now if you see, this is a right angle triangle. Now in the right angle triangle, this is hypotenuse. And hypotenuse is center distance D. This is R2 minus R1. So how much is this distance? We want this distance because this is same as this. So we are taking this distance twice. That means we are taking this distance twice. Now what is this distance? This is D cos alpha. So I'll write here 2 times. D cos alpha. D cos alpha. Now this angle is in degrees. Here is just a plain geometry. So D cos, D is D, 90 degrees here. So D cos alpha is this size and this length is same as here and here. So this becomes the total length of the belt. So what we want to know is, what is the length of the belt? This is the length of the belt. The part which is in contact with larger pulley, the part which is in contact with smaller pulley, and the part which is not in contact with any pulley, 2 times, one on this side and one on this side. That is the length of the belt. But suppose you are given this formula to find out the length of the belt, what you will have to find out, what you will require? You require the angle. From this point to this point, how much is this angle? Can you measure this angle? It is very difficult to measure the angle physically. So this theta 2 radians, theta 1 radians, now even in degrees, it is not possible to measure. Because we are given the data in terms of radius of the pulley and D. So we have got only these 3 things. Whereas what is the formula says, formula is saying something else. That means now we have to convert this formula into something consisting of R1, R2 and D. So how to convert this formula? That is the next thing we have to find out so that this becomes a usable formula. Now see what we do. First, we have to convert this radians into degrees. How that is converted? See here. Now, all of you know, pi radians means 180 degrees. So, I will take this ratio. So, this is same as theta in radians upon theta in degrees. So, the ratio of radians and degrees is like this. So, if this is the case, I can write theta radians is same as writing pi by 180 into theta degrees. Theta radians is pi by 180, theta degrees on this side, so that becomes our conversion point. So what we do is, now we use this formula here. So I'll write here, one more thing, this alpha which is written here, what is alpha equal to? Alpha is an angle, this angle. Now this alpha, can you say like this? Alpha, also, alpha is, see, so what is sine alpha? Sine alpha is the side which is in front of alpha upon the hypotenuse. So I can say that alpha is sine inverse of R2 minus R1 upon D. Can we say like this? Alpha is R2 minus R1 upon D. What we have done? We have changed alpha to what we are given. R1, R2D. So we have changed alpha in terms of the given data. So alpha is this. Alpha in degrees, of course, is like this. Even here also alpha is in degrees. So alpha in degrees is given by this. And angle in radius is given by this. So if it is theta 1, this will be theta 1. If it is theta 2, this will be theta 2. So now we will write the equation again. L equal to R2. Now instead of theta 2, radians we will write in degrees. So I will write pi by 180 into theta 1 degrees. Plus R1 pi by 180 theta, sorry, this is 2, theta 1 degrees. Plus 2 into bracket D cos cos of alpha. Now what is alpha? Alpha is this. Cos alpha of sine inverse of R2 minus R1 upon D. So now the equation has become like this. Now what is theta 2 degrees? Theta 2 degrees is this much, which is made up of 180 degrees plus alpha plus alpha. So right here, R2 into bracket pi by 180 into, now instead of theta 2 degrees, what is theta 2 degrees is 180 plus 2 alpha. So I'll write here 180 plus 2 alpha. Alpha means alpha here and alpha here. But we know alpha is this. So 2 times sine inverse of R2 minus R1 upon D. This is I written alpha, and then the bracket is complete. So this whole thing is up to this much. R2 and this first bracket. Next is this bracket. So right here plus R1 pi by 180 into theta 1. Now theta 1 is this theta. Now this theta 1 is 180 minus 2 times alpha. So I'll write here 180 minus 2, and alpha means this much. So sine inverse of R2 minus R1 upon D. Same like last time. Then the bracket is complete. Plus D cos sine inverse of so if you now see, if you look at this equation, although the equation is looking very big, what this equation consists of is something which is measurable. So you can see here pi by 180, you know R2, R2, R1, D, R2, R1, D, R2, R1, D. So everywhere it is R2, R1 and D. So the parameters which are given to us, R2, R1 and D, they are all used here, and angle in radians etc. is gone now. So how much is this angle of contact? How many radians, how many degrees? That is not required. Although the original formula consists of the angles in radians, which we have converted into degrees, and finally we are not used even in degrees, we are used their conversion factor, that theta 2 degrees is 180 plus 2 alpha, and alpha consists of R2 and R1 and D. So by making use of all these substitutions, this formula after substitution has become this formula. I'll just make it as a highlighted formula. So this formula, what you see here, is the formula to find out the length of the bed. Now you are not supposed to mug this up. It is not possible to remember it as it is. You should be able to derive it. And it is not so difficult because we know this. It is very easy to understand. Lengths in contact, twice the length not in contact. And then the conversion, radians to degrees, and alpha is converted like this. Then substitute all these radians, theta 2 radian, theta 1 radian and alpha, you put it here. And one more substitution is, this theta 2 is 180 plus 2 alpha, theta 1 is 180 minus 2 alpha. So that substitution, all the substitutions once you carry out, then the equation becomes this equation. And this will be useful for finding out the length of the belt for open belt system. Open belt system is like this, where it is like this. What is the other option? Cross belt system. Next thing is cross belt system. So we are now going to find out the length of the belt, second case, for a cross belt system where the belt is like this. It will go like this. Cross belt system, in which case the direction will be opposite. Now you can see here the direction is same. Clockwise, clockwise, clockwise. Now when it is cross like this, then one will rotate anticlockwise, other will rotate clockwise. So direction will be opposite. So that in that case, cross belt system, how do you find out the length of the belt? That is the next derivation which we will be seeing here. you can jot down this information till that time.